can't wait for my first Unite battle. Go get him, Score Bunny!
Welcome to Unite, loser.
Pokemon Unite is League of Legends for babies. It's an Aeon of Strife style. I need to stop making this joke. It's a MOBA, which if you don't know what that is, you should stop watching this video, because MOBAs are strictly for people that hate themselves and everyone around them. As an avid MOBA player, I got to enjoy the loveliest of stomps as I transferred my League know-how to Unite, and I bashed in the skulls of children that were trying out the game because it had Pokemon on the title and it was free to play. The game is actually kind of what I wanted as a permanent mode in League. The matches don't last longer than 10 minutes, as the objective isn't to destroy the enemy Nexus, but instead score as many buckets as possible. You do that at what would be towers, which don't actually defend themselves and rely on the players to do so. Despite multiple paragraph articles trying to make it seem more complicated, defending a goal can be summed up with hit them, dummy. Instead of three abilities and an ult, you have two and a Unite move. However, you can choose between two different moves at your Evolve level. So mirror matches of the same character can actually have different kits, but you'll only ever see the meta picks outside of one or two outliers that will probably feed. There's no shop, so returning to base is mostly only used to heal, allowing you to stay active and not be bogged down by menus or counter builds. A lot of people claim that the game is pay to win, but in reality, it's more of a handicap. It doesn't matter how much money you spend if you suck at the game, just like giving a monkey a shotgun doesn't guarantee him a victory in a death battle with a lion. There's still a 90% chance he'll just scream and throw poop. Sure, if you understand the game and become a pay pig, you'll definitely have a leg up and be able to stomp a lot easier. I do think the health item system is inherently dumb, as it's reminiscent of early League runes, where you were essentially punished for not already having 100 hours in the game out the gate. I'm not against having the items, but maybe either give more coins or have matchmaking based around item level then, as you can max out equipment without spending hundreds of dollars, but you'd probably have to have been playing since the game released. But ultimately, matches adopt the Splatoon ideology, where 90% of the game doesn't matter. And really, the last 2 minutes is what determines the victor, as points will be doubled and Zapdos can literally win games by giving everyone 20 buckets on top of the ability to defenseless dunk. Only the last hit on Zapdos matters, so even if you were sucking all game, if you get a lucky hit, you've probably got yourself a W. As someone who for God knows what reason has solo climbed all the way up to Masters, I think I can safely say that bottom tier and top tier is almost entirely the same. No matter what rank you are, you will still have teammates that do nothing all game, ignore objectives such as Dread or Zapdos, steal experience and do nothing with it, pick Zorora, Cinderace, or Greninja and go jungle when someone's already called it, or perhaps the worst of all, pick Venusaur in general. Sure, some of these die down in higher tier, and I've had multiple games where Zapdos was never even defeated, but you will always run into deadweights, and they are so much worse in this title than they are in other MOBAs. One deadweight can literally cost a game, and God forbid if you have multiples. Knowing the genre is filled with toxic people such as myself, they've limited communication and reports, but that doesn't stop me from blocking everyone that has a value under 30 and reporting them for maliciously idling. The game is rather punishing too, as there are no bans, meaning you can expect a Greninja and Cinderace every fucking game. Network issues can randomly disconnect you, and there is no method of remaking for an AFK. I think at the very least, I should be able to dodge a ranked game without penalty if anyone locks Venusaur. Seriously, he's a cool mon, but he's a lousy champ who I've never seen MVP. Outside of ranked, you have regular battles and then quick battles, which are on smaller maps with some gimmicks, which are nice if you're looking for an even faster mode. And seeing as how the game will eventually be coming to mobile, I can see this mode getting a lot more use. Ultimately, I do enjoy Unite, and the game's already gotten a new character with more on the way. They seem to be listening to player complaints too, so hopefully we'll see some item changes. I just hope they don't exclusively listen to the casuals for everything, which would cause the game to get watered down even more. At the end of the day though, winning can be achieved by abusing these three simple tricks. Pick anyone but Venusaur, don't pick Venusaur, make sure no one on your team is Venusaur.